Yeah. We are going to learn how to change font and font size, bold, use bold, underline, change case, highlight text, and font color on Microsoft Word 2013. First of all, you have to open your Microsoft Word application. Yeah. You have to open your Microsoft Word application. Yeah, first of all, you need to write something. Something. It's just an example. So don't mind what I have. Just an example. You click Control plus C to copy. Control plus V to paste. Yeah. Okay. So, how to change font? You know how to change font. Any time you want to change the font or change the color, you have to highlight it first. Yeah. To highlight it, you click on the left side of your mouse, you drag it, then you're going to choose font. Yeah, it depends on you, the font that you want. You have so many fonts, you can choose this. Yeah, you can decide to choose this. Or you can decide to choose this. That depends on you. You can decide to choose this. So the fonts base, the choice is yours. You can choose any choice, any font you like. You have so many ones. You have so many fonts. You can choose any font that you want. Choose any font that you want. But I will show you the default one. See, so you after you write it that you want, you come here and choose the font that you want. You have default ones. You see, the moment you put your cursor on it, it will definitely show you the type of font. This. So the default one is here. There's this one. That's the default one. So you see, yeah. And the size. The front size. You see, the moment you put your cursor, the size changes. You see, yeah. You see, I have another way to change the size. You come here. Increase front size. When you click it, it will be increased. It will increase. And you want to decrease it. And you come here and decrease it. But the normal and the default size of a text is 12. Yeah. The default size of a text is 12. And you can change the case. You click here. Click on this one and change the case. You can make it lowercase. See, everything has changed to the lowercase. You can make it uppercase, you see everything I changed to uppercase. So here changes the case. See, yeah. Let's see something. Let's go to normal. This case. So this case gives you the capital uppercase and the small case and sentence case. So if you want it to be bold, click here. You see, it's bold now. See, it's bold now. See. Bold normally used for heading. Bold normally used for heading. So bold. See, you can change it and make it 10. See, turn the light. Yeah, turn the light. Turn the light. You see, it's on the light. And the light, we have types. Click. Let's say. Yeah, you click here. You don't have types of underline. You can choose a type. You can come here for more. Come here for more. Right. Come here for more. So you can choose any line that you want. So you have more types. When you want it, you click it. And then click OK. You see, you have it here. You see, yeah, you have so many types of underline. So that is, look at this one too. Let me go back here. Yeah, this one is a strike through, throw something out by drawing a light through it. So you see this one, how it is used. Yeah, draw light through it. Draw light through it. See, yeah. So this one, you a small test, it brings you down. This one brings you up. See, yeah. So let's take it back. Okay. So here you can change. Yes. Test highlight color. To highlight the test, see, this normally helps when you are working on some document or some application, and you want to end to a certain point. So you come and continue. You want to remember where you end. You can highlight it. Yeah, so when you come, you will know where you can start. And highlight data, to highlight test, test highlight color means many things, right? Before you can do that, you just highlight it. Yeah, you can change the color. See. If you don't want it, you can. If you don't want the highlight, if you don't want it, you can come to. Local. You just highlight it. Yeah, see, it's gone. And we have test front color. You highlight it all and give the test color. And give the color blue. The color blue. See, So the test color. How to give the test color? Normally don't know normally happen. The default color is black. But in some cases you need to change the color. So if you highlight any word here, you can change the color. You see. So this is how to change color. See. This is how it is. This is how it is. To change test color. And then you have so many things. Change test color. Make the test work. You see, you have page color. Page color, you come to design and you click on design. The right side of your Microsoft application, after watermark, you find page color. Click on page color. You can give the page any color that you want. The white is not good for you. Any page color that you want, you can change the color to the color that you want. So see, I like this color. You see, it's not white, it's something like ash. So the default color is white. So you see, to change page color, change page color, and you can, you know, you have symbols. I choose a symbol that you want. See, it works. Let's click. You can choose a symbol that you want. The moment wherever you want the symbol to be, you just click that place and go click on symbol, find the symbol that you want, you click on the symbol. It should be the destination where the cursor is blinking. So you have to choose first the destination before you go to the symbol. You see? So that's how to position. Okay, we come to that. So this is how we give a color of a test front color. Thanks for watching.